Hello, this is Ultimate Aviation HD, and I'm standing here in front of an airport where normally you'll need a special VHF band receiver to overhear aviation communications coming from the air traffic control tower. Well, not anymore. In this video, I will teach you how to assemble and properly configure a DIY aviation band receiver, all done for just $15. For this project, you will need the following tools: a soldering iron, a flathead screwdriver, small pliers, a wire cutter, a 9-volt battery, and a piece of wire for the antenna. First things first, you have to purchase the DIY ATC receiver kit from eBay. The link for that is in the description below the video. Once you have finally got the kit, take all of the parts out of the package. Be careful not to lose anything, because the circuit will not work if one little part is not there. Now, it is time to assemble the receiver. Use your solder iron to place the electronic parts onto the circuit board. Now, if you have zero experience with electronics and soldering, I provided a couple of links to highly effective soldering tutorials down in the video description. Those should help you a lot. The kit package includes some very clear diagrams that show exactly where each component should go on the circuit board. Pay special attention that polarity-sensitive components are installed properly. If any capacitor, diode, or transmitter is installed the wrong way and current is given, the circuit may permanently burn out. Notice this big white part. This is a radio antenna connector. If you do not have a dedicated radio antenna, the receiver will work just as fine with a simple wire antenna, 1 to 2 feet in length. Attach the wire into one of the smaller holes like I did here. If you want to, you can enclose the circuit into an aluminum shell from eBay. The link for that is in the description. Once you think that you have a complete circuit, run a quick test. Plug in a battery and see if a hissing sound comes out. If you cannot hear anything, then refer to the troubleshooting instructions at the end of this video. Alright, now that you've got a working circuit, go to your nearest airport to test the receiver. I recommend going to a large airport with commercial flights, because it is a lot easier to pick up air traffic control conversations there as opposed to a small airfield. Once you are on the spot, turn on your radio and start listening. Slowly, turn the tuning knob through its full range. If you only hear the hissing noise or you are picking up public FM broadcast stations, the receiver must be in the wrong frequency range. To correct this, you should adjust the L6 tuning coil. This is the little green box that surrounds a copper coil. Use a non-metallic tool to adjust the coil. If you turn counterclockwise, you will raise the frequency range, making it possible to pick up aviation transmissions. Rotate the frequency knob again and search for a sound. This is just a search process, and whether or not you will pick up an aviation transmission depends on your patience. When you finally catch a transmission, stay in this frequency and continue listening. Now, notice the intermediate frequency transformer. This is a little silver box in the left half of the circuit. The IF transformer can enhance the human transmission voice. To do this, adjust the transformer with a screwdriver. Usually, the best result is achieved by making 2 to 3 turns from the top of the shield box. The sound should become much clearer, and the human voice should become a lot easier to understand.
Chinese 588, please continue on Alpha. Turn right on Kilo. Cross runway 31 left, and turn right on Kilo Charlie.
Alright, so now you've got a complete radio receiver that is able to pick up real-time aviation transmissions. Watch part 2 of this series to find out how to properly align the radio and tune into specific air traffic control stations. This is Ultimate Aviation HD, one of the fastest growing aviation channels on YouTube. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and drop a comment down below with what you think about this video. Now it's time to move on to the troubleshooting instructions. Alright, first things first. If you have any questions, concerns, or problems, comment down in the video description, and I will gladly help you. This is the fastest and most practical way to solve any problem. Now let's look at some known issues. The circuit doesn't work at all. If the radio remains totally silent, your best bet is to recheck all of your work. Look over the circuit board and check for any mistakes in soldering, such as an unintentional solder splash. Now check the polarities of the batteries, speaker, and all diodes and capacitors. If still nothing works, get out the assembly diagram and check the correct values of all resistors. These tiny numbers are hard to read, so this is a very common mistake. If still nothing works, then your only option is to ask me for help. I will try to help you as much as I can. I can hear nothing but noise. Another very common problem is that you can pick up nothing except the hissing noise. There are two main reasons why this could happen. Number one, there are no aviation transmissions at the time, or you are too far away from an airport. The best way to solve this is to test your radio at a major airport with commercial flights. This greatly increases the amount of ATC transmissions. Reason number two, your IF transformer may be peaking the noise, making it impossible to hear any transmissions. By default, the transformer should be adjusted 2 to 3 turns from the top. Set it to that position, and now try searching for a signal. Now the discovery of a signal depends on your personal patience. Alright, so that wraps up this video. I wish you good luck on this project, and be sure to not miss part 2 of this series.